Tumi's Supermarkets was once one of the most iconic retail giants in Kenya. Serving as a major player in the East African retail market for over four decades. Its name, Uchumi, meaning economy in Swahili, reflected its ambition to provide accessible and affordable goods for the people. The supermarket chain, however, went from being a household name to facing imminent collapse. Here is the story of Uchumi's rise and fall. Uchumi Supermarkets was founded in 1975 as a public limited liability company by three Kenyan parastatals: Industrial and Commercial Development Corporation, Kenya Wine Agencies Limited, and Kenya National Trading Corporation. The goal was to create retail outlets for Kenyan manufacturers and ensure equitable distribution of commodities across the country. In 1976, Uchumi partnered with the Italian supermarket chain Standard, SPA, to train Kenyans in running the enterprise. By 1992, Uchumi had become a pioneer in the region by listing its shares on the National Nairobi Stock Exchange, NSE, making its growth and success. By then, the Nairobi Stock Exchange was the name. For now, it's called the Nairobi Securities Exchange. One of the biggest securities exchanges in Africa. By the late 1990s and early 2000s, Uchumi was a market leader in Kenya's retail sector. The supermarket chain was synonymous with quality and affordability, attracting customers from all walks of life. Its strategic location in urban centers' diverse product offering made it a favorite shopping destination. At its peak, Uchumi had numerous branches across Kenya and began expanding into neighboring countries such as Uganda and Tanzania. Despite its success, Uchumi faced significant challenges, primarily due to poor corporate governance and financial mismanagement. In June 2006, after 30 years in business, Uchumi was placed in receivership and delisted from Nairobi Securities Exchange. The closure was deemed one of the greatest corporate disasters in independent Kenyan history. The company struggled with debt, inventory shortages, and operational inefficiencies, leading to its temporary closure. A government-led rescue plan was initiated to revive Uchumi. And in July 2006, five branches in Nairobi were reopened under interim management. By January 2011, Uchumi had returned to profitability and relisted to Nairobi Securities Exchange in May of that year. The company aimed to regain its market position and expand further. In 2015, Uchumi underwent significant leadership changes. The company fired its chief executive officer, CEO, and chief financial officer for misconduct and gross negligence, and hired a new CEO to lead the turnaround efforts. However, the challenges persisted, and Uchumi announced the closure of all its stores in Uganda and Tanzania due to unprofitability, resulting to the layoff of 900 employees in those countries. As of 2023, Uchumi faced mounting debt of $3.6 billion, approximately $224 million, and struggled to remain afloat. The company relied on collective bargaining agreement CBA with creditors to erase its financial burden. Despite efforts to restructure and revive the business, Uchumi continued to grapple with operational challenges and fierce competition from local and international retailers in Kenya. Uchumi's survival hinged on securing agreements with creditors, but the pressure mounted as debt levels remained unsustainable. The company's chief executive, Mohamed Mohamed, expressed optimism but acknowledged the risk of liquidation if agreements failed. The company's inability to secure necessary support from creditors threatened its existence. While Uchumi struggled, competitors such as Naivas, Quickmart, and Carrefour gained ground, occupying the market space left by Uchumi and Nakumat, another collapsed giant, as well as Tuskys. The shift in consumer preferences toward more efficient and innovative retail experiences further eroded Uchumi's market share. Uchumi's downfall serves as a cautionary tale of importance and of corporate governance financial accountability. The company's struggles highlight the consequences of mismanagement and the need to transparency and integrity in business operations. The retail sector is dynamic, requiring businesses to accept changing consumer preferences and market conditions. Uchumi's failure to innovate and compete effectively underscores the importance of staying relevant to the customer needs. Despite its challenges, this story is not yet over. The company continues to explore avenues for recovery and remains a symbol of resilience in the face of adversity. The lessons learned from the rise and fall of Uchumi may guide its effort to reclaim its place in Kenya's retail landscape. In conclusion, Uchumi Supermarket's journey from a celebrated retail giant to a struggling enterprise is a reflection of complex and competitive nature of retail industry. Its story serves as one of the need for strong leadership, strategic planning, adaptability in ever-evolving market. While Uchumi's future remains uncertain, its legacy as a pioneer in Kenya's retail sector endures. There is a narrative, the Chris Kirubi had been, the late Chris Kirubi, when Uchumi started facing problem when he became in charge of that supermarket. And so he was acquitted of the charges, and a lot of this giant that was established during the Jomo Kenyatta era has fallen down. And we believe that they will try to, the government can fund it and revive it so that it can start working. And so this company was the pride of Africa and Kenya as a whole. So we believe that it may come to pass that they revive this giant, the sleeping giant of Uchumi. So guys, in case you are new to this channel, kindly consider subscribing and hitting the notification bell so that we can reach you. You can get more videos from us, and that is the only way you can support this channel. And so we also have a website. We offer SEO services. We offer branding. So in case you need a personal blog, a company website, you can reach out to me and we see how we can go around that. We offer consultancy services as well. And once you are ready, you need to start your own blog, you can let me know. You can just go to one of my social, my number is online. You just search Nyongesa Sunday phone number. You will get me and you can call me. You can WhatsApp me as well. So we are here to work and to help our people do stuff that can be of beneficial to them. Guys, if you have internet and you use only the internet to watch television, I bet you can change it and use that internet to do something online that can be of benefit to all, me and you, by creating content, by having just a blog and giving us information that we want while we browse online. And so it will be beneficial for all. So in case you need PR services, website, all these kind of things, branding, logos, we are here to do for you. So guys, thank you so much, and I believe we're just happy for your support, and continue watching our videos. Thank you so much, and see you in our next videos.